Hi Virgo, this is House of Virgo doing your love reading for the next 24 hours. This will be for Virgo Sun, Moon, Rising, or Venus. Some of the messages may or may not resonate, just take what fits, leave the rest. Personal reading links are below this video in the description box. You can also follow me on Instagram, House of Virgo. Please do hit like on the video if you so enjoy it. And please do subscribe if you're new to my channel. I would greatly appreciate that. Okay, Virgo. So the past position here. Okay, so a love reading can generally be about a romantic relationship, but it could also have to do with all things under the umbrella of love, friend, family. So it really just depends on your situation. Okay, so past, we have the Hermit and the Hierophant. So Virgo and Taurus energy. Five of Pentacles in the present, Four of Swords, the Nine of Swords, and the Four of Pentacles. Okay. Oh, Queen of Wands again. In the last two readings, last 2 days. Three of Wands. Okay, and the Queen of Pentacles. Interesting, Virgo. Okay. All right, give me a second here to see. There's definitely anxiety and stress I'm seeing here at the center of the reading. I feel like in the past there was a... silence, withdrawal, somebody going into process, think things through, seeking clarity, like a quest for personal truth. And I feel like it had something to do with expectations or conforming to something. Usually the Hierophant can represent conforming to a structure in a relationship, okay? Could be committing to something, okay? Committing to a structured type of environment. And that Five of Pentacles energy makes me feel like there was worry about that. I'm seeing isolation, bookending this committed thing. It was like right in the center. It was like being presented in the past. And there was a feeling of struggle about this. Worry about finances. Some physical health. Feeling incapacitated or incapable of doing something, committing to something long term. There might have been this somebody that you connected with in the past that just always kind of ran from that or had like a rebellious nature, didn't want to need somebody. Didn't want to have to like fall in line. Didn't want to have to depend or be viewed as someone who needed you. Didn't want to be seen in that light, either financially or in a relationship emotionally. Okay, let's get a clarifying card for the Hermit. There's a lot of thought being put into a relationship, whether to commit. Yeah, Eight of Cups, withdrawing emotionally. Somebody in your past just withdrew on a personal quest for truth. That Ace of Cups, will they be let down? Will they let you down? Are they too depressed? Will they be disappointed? Disappointment in the self, Okay. Can they be in a committed relationship? Are they capable? Are they willing to have a baby? Can they do that? Can they be married? Should they make a proposal? What it's like, just deep-seated thinking, and that Eight of Cups energy, that withdrawal. There was a maybe they abandoned you, or maybe it felt that way, that they had to pull away. Okay. And it kind of made it seem like this person like ghosted you or moved on or they were retreating. But I really feel like their energy was pulled away because if there was a concern about not being able to hold up their end of the hold up the expectation of what you needed from them. Okay, let's take a look at the Hierophant. Five of Cups. This person, whoever you're dealing with or were dealing with, they have a problem with their worth, their self-worth. They don't know if they didn't know if they could love themselves enough to love you. A sense of grief or abandonment that they carry with them. Somebody might have left them in the past, and that kind of started a chain reaction with this person, that they were just had this sense of sadness or avoidance, had a hard time believing in commitment or romantic love, or a hard time with even being someone who could ever be married, like long term, or have a long-term partnership. And so there was an issue, their struggle with possibly feeling overwhelmed with the duties or the expectations. Okay. Now the Five of Pentacles. What can you tell us about the Five of Pentacles? Okay, the Moon. Wow. This person struggled with their wanting to be free and wild. To them, partnership and a committed relationship, or just, I told you there was like an issue with rebelliousness. This person struggled with, should I, am I someone who can be domesticated, so to speak, or am I someone who needs to stay in my wild freedom, that kind of thing? And the Moon, it's the emotions, the things, the unseen things that they've kept have been presented to, were presented to them in the past about your relationship. I feel like if this Moon energy hadn't come, or these things hadn't been brought to them, their deepest feelings, they would have just kept them down because they were called to action. And it seems like they pulled away or they ran away when it came to really getting committed or really committing to something in their life. So the current energy for this person. So let me just say real quick, there's also Piscean energy. Leo, Aries, Sagittarius, Capricorn. Okay, for those of you who, need to know. The present energy, okay. King of Pentacles is here. This person is they're thinking about you, that's for sure. And they're thinking about their ability presently. They really have it on their mind if they are someone who could be a solid and good, strong leader in your life, or someone who can be quite stable. I feel like this person presently is like going through some stress. Some nights they can't sleep, other nights they're resting in peace. There's perhaps some nightmares at times, stressful thinking, thoughts. But when they envision themselves as being someone who can be stable and maybe financially well off, male or female, it doesn't matter. They view you that way. When they think of you, it brings them peace. It does. It brings them a sense of peace because you represent safety and home to this person. But and they wish, I feel like this person is currently, you know, taking that step back here and trying to envision themselves as someone who can be there for you. But tell us about this Nine of Swords. What is this stress? Even be there financially or be in a better position financially? Three of Wands. But they stress. They have extreme grief, or maybe they're going through some depression. You know, not extreme, it's light. They have mood swings, I feel. But when they're in their negative, anxiety-ridden period, some of it has to do with their ability. They still stress if they're able to. They envision themselves being able to, and then at other times they envision themselves as not being able to be part of a team, as not being able to expand upon the relationship, right? And that right there, it's like negative thinking. And then they get themselves kind of lost. And then they're kind of up and down with it. It just feels like with these four cards here that they're undecided. You know, do I be wild and free and irresponsible and just go with the run with the wolves? You know, do I stay a lone wolf, or do I come into union? Do I commit? Do I make something work here? But they struggle with their self-worth and they don't know if they can do it. So the Four of Pentacles is here to tell me that the truth is that, Virgo, this person does have a desire for long-term security with you. They do. And in the present, I feel like they don't want to let you go. Tell me more about this Four of Pentacles. Yep. Ace of Cups. They know. They do know. They feel it in their heart. Their head is like, ooh. But when they're at rest and at peace, they know that they can give you what you need. And the reason they don't want to let you go is because they're currently seeing they need to have courage. The Ace of Cups brings in an energy, an emotional new beginning, an initiation, a huge potential. They don't want to let you go because they see that there's a love potential here with you, but they struggle with their inner demons. So what's happening here going forward? The Queen of Wands is courage. And the Three of Wands again with the Queen of Pentacles, okay? They get this courage going forward after these 24 hours at some point. They get their confidence back. I don't know how they're doing that. I feel like it's because they're given a blessing. It's almost like a higher power comes in, a spiritual grace that infuses their heart. It has a huge effect on them. You know, it's grace, because if it were left up to them, they would just be confused or lost. This person might be secretly getting some type of spiritual help, or they've come across something has just come down onto them, you know, like something causes their cup to overflow. And I partially feel like they come to this place where they realize that they don't want to let you go and they want this love because they see so much potential with you. Their struggle is to see it within themselves, but they do come to this Queen of Wands energy. Tell us more about this. Yeah. Mm-hmm. they do see here the Seven of Cups that, you know, they have options. They know it. But I also feel like all those options that they have, no one's choosing them. Or when they begin, your person is coming to terms with the fact that they, everybody was always a potential. Look at all those one cups. Each cup represents a new potential. Everyone was always a potential. What makes you the one? Because when they think of you, when they dream about you at night, when they think about you, they see you, male or female, as someone who is domesticated. You represent something that they have always fought against. Perhaps they were just selfish for a long time and never truly self-sacrificing for others. They may not have felt worthy enough to that anybody would want them to do that. You bring something to them, Virgo. Let me just get a King of Pentacles clarifier. Two of Wands, yep. They also see that you've been waiting for them. That you were someone who was willing to wait for them. That you chose them, okay? And that you were supportive and compassionate towards them. And that you were a friend to them. I feel like your person was just kind of always visions of grandeur. And I see them getting their self-assuredness and their confidence back in regards to the fact that they were just spreading themselves thin for a long time. Okay? They get some truth. For sure. It's karma. It's not really negative karma. It's positive karma because the truth comes in. A win-win with justice. This is Libra energy. Cause and effect. Okay? This person is seeing that there were consequences to their decision to just stay wild and free because, you know, they're having a lot of anxiety. I don't know if they're having some kind of shift or change in their life here, but justice is coming in and forcing them to find a win-win solution in their life. Justice is forcing them to be truthful and honest with themselves and to be fair and reasonable and to really take a look at where they are in their life right now and where they are without you if you're not in communication or if there's a chance to lose you. So the Three of Wands is here yet again, which tells me that this person is expanding now. Tell me about the Three of Wands. Strength, courage, success. This person somehow, I don't know, I feel like you inspire them. That Ace of Cups is a card of inspiration. Something happens in the present that inspires this person to love you. It might be something that comes from you or just something that they experience in their life. The love, the inspiration is stronger than their desire to run away from it. It's a Leo energy. Even material happiness. Joy. Virgo, you have a way to tame this person. You tame the wild beast in them. You have tamed them. They recognize this. And they needed that. Because they were just running free with the wolves. You know? Just a relentless, everyday freedom, but like there was a lack of emotional connection. The wolves don't have emotional connection. They have instinctual, you know, transactional type of relationships, but you inspire this person and warm their heart. And you give them strength. So the Queen of Pentacles energy is here, and that's you. You're the end all be all to this reading, Virgo. Clarify. Oh. Two of Cups. This person, whoever they are in your life, the romance comes back, the partnership, there's a proposal or marriage, it comes, there's union here. You guys definitely have an understanding, there's a mutuality in your love, in your exchange, there's a connection, there's camaraderie, there's two people who are on the same page, who understand one another. There's balance, there's duality. There's diversity between the two of you. There are some very strong differences between the two of you. Could be in your emotional expressions, your physical look. It could be in the way you speak to each other or the way you think. It could just even be diversity in your creative aspects of life and the things you do. But regardless, there's an understanding between the two of you, and I feel like your person begins to see there is a very good connection here. What a way to end your reading. Let's get some angel wisdom cards here to see what the messages are for you, Virgo, and your person. Please remember to hit like, share, and subscribe while you're watching this video. I greatly appreciate that. Okay. Yeah, Nine of Swords right here again. Still, that is the overall theme for the reading. This person has huge anxieties, unfounded fears. That's true. This person has a tendency to expect the worst, thus creating self-fulfilling prophecies. They allow their worry to grow out of proportion to all situations, sleepless nights. They're being asked, and they are beginning to refocus their thoughts, but the love is inspiring them to do so. Or, you know, it is in the present for sure. A lot of thinking, a lot. This person might be thinking way too much, overthinking things because the fear and the worry is driving them. Page of Cups, sensitive, open-hearted, inexperienced, moody. That's your person. They have those. They may have an inexperience in relationships, or, you know, they're very sensitive. They have a tendency towards mood swings, and I think I said that before. But they are a very open-hearted person, okay? So there are messages here coming from them regarding your relationship. The new emotional experiences. There's a romance coming here. There could be they invite you to a social something or event. There's a lot. There's heightened psychic abilities between the two of you. I feel like you guys can feel each other's energy. I feel like, and that would be very similar to a twin flame connection. But I feel like when you're not communicating with them or there's time apart and you have a sudden emotion that just comes and it's completely out of the blue and you don't know why, if you've experienced that, you're feeling something with them. If you have some nights where you have trouble sleeping, you don't know why, because maybe three nights prior you slept like a baby, but now all of a sudden you can't sleep and there's nothing really going on and you don't feel stressed and you can't figure it out, that's your person. That's what you're feeling. You're feeling their energy, because you are both connected. Look at the energy that comes from the connection here. It's like a surge of power between the two of you. Okay. The Star. Talk about energy. The Star is the biggest ball of energy in the sky. Okay. The Star is the sun. The sun is here. No, it's not. Strength. The Star. Having faith. The future is bright. Dreams coming true. Positive changes that bring an end to these challenging times. There is light at the end of the tunnel, Virgo. Okay. There's renewal. There's hope. Clarity comes. A miracle is happening here. And you're both being asked to have faith. Light is being shown. That's Aquarian energy. Light is being shown down on this relationship, on this love. There may have been a time in this connection where you felt ignored. There may have been a physical impotence. There may have been a feeling, or somebody may have been very arrogant, or again, depression or some type of illness while there's healing from all of that happening here, Virgo. So it looks very beautiful, very, very beautiful. Healing of anxieties and stress. And it's all coming from this Ace of Cups, this inspiration of love. Could be coming from you, could be just coming from spirit for this person. But whatever, it doesn't matter. It's there. It shows up in the present. And that sets off a chain reaction of change and healing. All right, Virgo, so I hope you enjoyed that. Do click like and subscribe to my channel if you did. You can also follow me on my other channel, Moon Pie Tarot. And I will see you all very, very soon. I'll see you in 24 hours. Okay, take care. Bye.